Look how big Fryers is. I tell you, that number four is bigger than I am.
And what a name for a big, brawny guy like him in the middle. Sam Hammer. I mean, that's a name. That's a name.
He's big. He's about 6'3", 6'4", something like that. Oh. Eighth grade. I was 6'3", I guess, in eighth grade. I don't think I was that big, though.
Sam gets it over to Stubblefield. Stubblefield gets it to 34, Pat Weiss, and I think it's Weiss, isn't it?
It's Weiss.
Weiss?
Yeah.
In the middle to Sam the Hammer. Oh, just powered his way past Big Dan Vogel, who's no little guy himself, but I mean, this guy is huge.
I was so excited I put four down instead of two.
Billy Rizzo kicks it over to Kelly, back out to Rizzo. Gets across to Smiley with a one-hander, boom. No problem. Put it in from out here, you put it in from in there.
Yeah, take that.
Weiss comes down the floor, takes one from 18, no good. Stubblefield over the back. Hammer misses the layup. Hammer back up again, and that's power in there.
Hey, looks familiar, you know. I love that.
Me too. In a 1-2-2 zone, Friars is. Getting it to get some wing shots. Get a high-low post. Get it overloaded. Running one-hander by 14, Robert Kelly. Goes out of bounds off of Todd Smiley. Weiss the inbounds to O'Connor. 4-2, Friars leads early.
I remember Weiss about 4 years ago, I guess, playing fifth grade. It was something else. He was good back then.
Argus gets it into Stubblefield, up and in. Billy Rizzo gets it over to Kelly, back to Rizzo. They got a big guy. This is a big team, this Friars team. Man, they are huge. The guy guarding the point is as big as KSC's center. Rizzo drives up the middle, no good. Hammer with the rebound. Kicks it out, 42, Mike Argus. Broken up real nice by Robert Kelly, but he fouls him.
This is big. I'm telling you what, there's not freshman teams or junior varsity this big.
Sean nice O'Connor. Shot. Hammer pushed in on 21.
Yeah, trying to get a little position. 30. What they need right now to do is KSC try to get the ball in the middle once or twice. You know, they have to. They're just, as soon as these guys bring the ball down, they're just waiting for these guys. And they know they're going to shoot from outside.
Smiley over to Kelly, puts it up off the front of the rim, no good. Hammer with a long rebound. Oops, kicks it off of Hammer's foot, but they were lucky.
He's got to make that shot if they want to stay in this game.
Connor gets it over to Argus. Argus drives, cut off, back out to O'Connor through Weiss hands. Just didn't look the ball into his hands.
Right now, I think I'd take 14, switch him around a little bit more. They did it last time. They took him down to the wing. I don't understand. He's a pretty good shooter when he gets hot.
Okay, Billy Rizzo brings the ball up.
Now they're going to keep backing on the wing again. Called timeout. Well, it's a 6-2.
Big guys are winning.
Real big guys are winning.
It's a huge team, I'll tell you.
Big team, I'll tell you. I've never seen a team this big before. Gee, they're eighth graders, Jim.
Ah, they can't be. I wasn't that big when I was in the eighth grade.
I'll tell you what,
of course, I'm still not that big. So, they are huge. They are huge. Okay, 6-2 is the score. Fryer leads with 3:37 left in the first quarter. And it's going to be interesting to see what KSC is going to do. What KSC wants to do is run the floor with this team because they can't play half-court basketball with
right.
them. They have to get this game moving up and down. Rizzo gets the ball over in the corner, Smiley. Good defensive reaction over there, though. Back to Kelly. Kelly's got O'Connor all over him. Nice hands by Sean O'Connor. Real good hands over there on the wing on the defense.
Anticipation, he knew exactly what he was going to do. these guys play together each other. I benched my four or five times already this year.
Kelly out to Rizzo. Back to Kelly. Connor with his hands on him. Rizzo. Off-balance shot. They've got him down as Duryea, but I'll swear his name's Andy Pearson, a redhead.
Someone's hurt. Someone hurt his knee. It looked like...
Pat Vice is down on the floor.
It looked like he twisted his knee. It wasn't really no contact. I might have hit knees with somebody else. That's painful.
Yeah.
That's a good view of Syria Fieldhouse as we'll be playing all these games in the next 4 weeks. There's a score with 3:09 left, 6-2. Home team is Friars.
Game started out kind of slow here, but I'm sure you're going to see it pick up.
Must have a trick knee or something, Jim. I really don't know what happened there. I see him bend over. He was bent over for a while like that. He looks okay. He walked off the floor.
Okay, Sean O'Connor's going to inbound. Get in the new player in the game, 25, Dan Lawrence. Nice steal there. Nice steal by 25 for KSC. That's Dan Vogel. Kick it around. Friars real back on defense real quick. Tell you what, they're a big team, but they're not slow. There's Todd Smiley puts another one in. He's got two real nice baskets from outside. The ball to Sam Hammer. I'm going to call him Mike Hammer all the time. Sam gets it back to Sean O'Connor.
Wise. Getting back to a guard.
Over to Argus. Argus kicks it into Stubblefield. Real good flash into the pivot there. Nothing Andy Pearson can do about that. Billy Rizzo comes up, kicks it over to Kelly. Kelly's open. Over Hammer, partially deflected. Good position by Andy Pearson. Good position by Andy Pearson, and it draws a foul.
Foul number 25, Dan Lawrence.
On Dan Lawrence. Billy Rizzo is going to inbound. Got big Stubblefield kid right over the top of him. He's huge. Get it into Kelly, over to Smiley, back to Kelly. Rizzo puts it back on the point. Now Kelly takes the point. Over to Billy Rizzo in the wing. Drives down in the corner into Pearson.
Someone should have been there.
Blind pass.
Like a set, yeah, it's a set play. They're right in front of us now.
Sean gets it into Stubblefield under a good defensive pressure. Double dribble. Brought the ball down and then started dribbling again. Going to run the double screen here, Coach Rizzo says. Here we go. Billy comes over, gets it to Smiley at the wing, back to Billy Rizzo. There they are, they're trying to spring Smiley, get it to Kelly. Get it inside, blocked by Stubblefield, but he already took a little travel. Did Dan Vogel. Slow start, 8-4, Friars leads with a minute 50 left in the first period. Touch foul called on Todd Smiley. Billy Rizzo with good anticipation. Gets it down to Kelly, puts it up. It's good. 8-6, just a 2-point lead now for Friars. Sam Hammer gets the ball. He's fouled by Todd Smiley. That's a good call. It's two quick fouls on Todd.
I don't think they can afford to lose him, the way he's been shooting the ball from outside so far this game.
Number 15, Greg Lurk, comes in the game. We just talked about his dad down there before, and he's here to see Greg play tonight. Got to do something about his uniform. We got two teams with white uniforms on. It's hard to pick them up. Number 40, Mike Castleman. Way outside, Argus, no good. Rebounded by Bobby Kelly. Bobby comes into the middle. He's looking. He's going to get it over to Rizzo, put his feet together, and boom. Oh, no good. Hammer with a rebound. Gets it over to 25. Dan Lawrence. It's stolen. Real nice. Rizzo beats Argus to the ball. Comes across, gets it to Lawrence. No good. Dan Vogel misses a 15-footer. Kelly comes over and cuts him off. Him and Vogel have a double team. Bad call.
what they're doing now. They're just two guards are pressing. That's all. That's all they can afford to do is just two guards pressing. They're really shaking up the bigger team. I think they should have done this just a little earlier.
Rizzo to Lurk, back to Rizzo at the point. They run a double screen for Lurk. Get it to Smiley, or to Kelly. They're going to play for one shot. There's 35 seconds left in the first quarter. No pressure, so they'll hold it. They're passing the ball. They can't get a count on them. Kelly from way outside, as he used to just block the ball down in his hands. Nice little soccer move in there by Dan Vogel. Inbound
Kelly's
into Lawrence.
Set up and shoot.
The ball to Stubblefield on the side. Puts the ball on the floor, which might be a mistake. But he goes past him. Number 40, Castleman in and puts it in. 12-11, Friars takes a one-point lead in a seesaw match. Kelly back out to Rizzo. Rizzo to Greg Lurk. Greg's covered. Greg. Rizzo with a force. Running 12-foot bank. Good.
That's always going, don't they?
I'm telling. Get the ball into Stubblefield. Got a blocking foul called on Bobby Kelly. Didn't get his position. Whoa, the referee just ran right into Sam Hammer, and
old Hammer, the big
old
guy.
Hammer. Ball in the big Hammer. Sam, nice play by Pearson, saves a sure basket. Real good hustle, quickness. Got him.
That's right, use your quickness.
They call play three. They're looking in the middle of Big Sam, and I would too. It's too easy. Way too easy. 1 point lead for the Friars Club now. Greg Lurk gets it over to Rizzo. Back to Greg. Looks for Bobby Kelly on the right wing. Bobby left a position on him. Got a new player, number 22. Casey Moore in for Northside. Pearson over the top of Hammer. Totally intimidated.
Sure.
Castleman gets the ball over to Pat Vyth. Pat got away with a carry right in front of us. Sean O'Connor up to Stubblefield. Gets the ball across 10-second line. Vyth comes in on the right side. Rizzo cuts him off.
His knee doesn't look like it's bothering him too much.
Looks good. Mike Argus gets it in the corner to Stubblefield. 18. Back out the long bomb by number 30. Sean O'Connor off the rim, no good. Pearson brings it up. He's looking for an impossible pass, but he gets it. Kelly, reverse layup, no good. Knocked out of bounds by Sean O'Connor. He should have went up and grabbed it. Tell you what, with the two white shirts, these teams are having a hard time with each other. They don't know who to block out and who to leave get the rebound. Pearson's got inside position. Good layup. Real nice job using his body on a much taller Mike Argus underneath there. O'Connor gets it up to Stubblefield. They break the 10-second line. Loses control, gets away with a little stroll. O'Connor over to Vyth. Argus on the wing. Stubblefield runs a baseline, nothing there. Vyth from 18, cut off by Bobby Kelly into Big Sam, the man. Hammer puts it in and knocks his glasses off. He don't need those glasses. He shoots real good without them.
Nice. Got a nice touch from the outside, too. He just showed me.
Yep, that was it. A little 8-foot turnaround. That's tough.
For a big kid like that. Usually they're sort of uncoordinated a little bit.
He's not.
No.
Billy Rizzo, tap pass into Pearson, just like they planted. Kelly.
Knocked it out.
Lurk sets a nice screen on Argus. Get it inside to Billy. And with the trees, no good. Sam the man comes down with the hammer. He comes in with a hammer.
Get the ball out. Like how he gets the ball out, too, you know. I like how he gets the ball out real quick and take down. Runs a four real well.
Yeah. Pat Vyth got caught with a little happy feet movement there.
Happy feet. Number 11, Todd Smiley. Here comes Todd Smiley back in. He's got two fouls. We've got two quick fouls, and we got 2 minutes left to go in the second quarter.
They need his shooting touch in there too. He's a nice shooter. Lurk to Todd, back to Greg. Trying to get some perimeter passing, looking for openings inside. The guys inside are really working hard for Cassie. Bad pass. It was cross-court by Greg Lurk. Pat Weiss comes down. Lurk's got defensive position on him. Weiss around him, up and in with a scoop. Nice scoop by Pat Weiss. Three-point lead for Friars. They get the ball to Smiley. Back out to the point to Greg Lurk. Looking for Bobby Kelly. Back to Lurk. We haven't just gotten better in naming names, folks. We've seen these kids play for a lot of years. Almost know this team like the ones that I coached. Okay, Andy Pearson gets the ball down on the baseline, calls for timeout with 1:07 left, and they're down 3 to Friars.
You know, I've been noticing them with the Friars, or not the Friars, but the Northside team. They got a lot of perimeter passing, and they really don't do anything. You've been noticing that, too?
Well, they're
back and forth.
They're looking inside.
Flash somebody in the middle. You don't have to be in the middle. It could be out, like, by the foul line, but you've got to do that.
I really think they're having a hard time recognizing who's the offensive player and who's the defensive player with everybody having a white shirt on. It's just, it's real hard to do because kids just see a color out of the side of their eye and they're going to hit it. Well, you can't see a color out of the side of your eye.
From where I was shooting, it didn't matter.
That's true. Hell,
no one would guard me from that far out. That guy won't do that.
You started shooting as soon as you got on the last step of the bus. I won't say you shot the long one, but get it into 20, Dan Duryea. I know it's not Dan Duryea, it's Paul Duryea. Wasn't he an actor? From Hollywood.
No, Paul Newman.
Oh, Paul Newman. He's the one I keep mistaken with Tim Mathis. Oh, there's Smiley. You can can those. Oh, he doesn't miss that shot often. Nice rebound by Mike Argus. Gets it over to Sean O'Connor. Sean brings the ball up. Lurk, a little pressure. They get the ball up to Weiss. In the middle to Sam the Man. Hammer over to Castleman. Up. No good. Rebound. Weak side. Argus up and in. I'll tell you what. Eric Yarbrough has been coaching some basketball for a lot of years. I coached against him. That's how long ago he's been coaching. And he's got this team's big, they're skilled, and they're drilled. I'm telling you, they're really playing good basketball.
The big three.
Skilled, drilled, and big.
I mean, they can play the game, and they're well coached. Eric Yarbrough, like I said, I'd go way back with Eric, and he's one of the real good coaches in the Cincinnati area.
You know, you hear a lot about the high school coaches that have been around a long time, and I want to tell you something. They got nothing on a guy like Eric Yarbrough. He can coach the game. It doesn't matter where. He knows the game, and he coaches it.
Sure. We got We got Big Sam. He's got 10 points that first half.
I'll tell you.
They couldn't stop him.
Who's got
22 points?
I don't think you and I could double-team him and stop him. And, I mean, I'm a great defensive player. I'll tell you, I've seen a lot of your defense over the years. And
defense? What's defense?
That's when you put on your right guard. That's the only defense you know.
Clyre's got a nice shot there, don't he?
Yeah. Trying to break the camera lens.
That'll do it.
Yeah. Okay, Friars is going to have the ball out to start the second half.
Well, next week, Jim, be the same time, same place.
Same station.
Yeah. Starting at 6:30, going all the way to 9:30, our last game starts. Come on up. A lot of food, a lot of drinks, a lot of fun.
Hot doughy pretzels, I'm telling you. Well, there's more whistles out here than a cops convention, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay, Pat Weiss going to inbound the ball. Guess who they look for? The tallest pair of hands, Weiss. Stubblefield, oh, he didn't slam it. Knocked out of there real nice on the Stubblefield comes back with the ball, no good. Weiss with a stick back, up and in, it's going to count. We got a call on little Billy Rizzo's in there fighting for his life. He needs an axe. Or a chainsaw or something, because, man, those are some sequoias.
Big guys in there.
Billy Rizzo is first.
24-17, big three-point play if he can can this one to start the second half. I'll tell you, that's going to mean a lot in this ball game. Misses the ball, Stubblefield, oh man, puts it up, no good. Sam the Man Hammer is up in there, he gets it. Oh, they said he traveled, oh no.
I like his temperament. You know, he looked over at the referee and goes, he shook his head like, yeah, I guess I did it.
Okay.
He's not going to change anything. Might as well get on the good side of him. That's where I always look at it. I never argue with a referee at all.
Wait, come on, Gary. I got a game to call here. Okay, Billy Rizzo out on a point. Yo-yos it over to Smiley. He's open. Off the back of the rim, Big Sam comes down with a rebound. Smiley didn't want any part of that. Vice going to go right over Rizzo, I'll tell you that right now. 26-17, a 9-point bulge now for Friars. Rizzo gets the ball from Bobby Kelly. Bobby looks over to Todd. Smiley can't find anything inside. Good defense by Friars. They're playing some real nice basketball. Kelly drives, opens it up, gets it over to Pearson, drives the baseline. Ball is blocked by Sean O'Connor. Here comes Mike Argus on the left side with the left hand. That's the way you should play it too, folks. You kids out there, you watch that. You're on the left side of the floor. You use your left hand and shield your ball with your body. Comes Andy Pearson, comes up, goes around Stubblefield. Going to the basket underneath the Smiley, puts it up and in, and he's fouled by Sam Hammer. And when the hammer hits you, you've been hammered.
You've been hammered.
You've been hammered. 26-19. Todd can bring his team to within six with 4 minutes and 38 seconds left in the third period. Nice shot of the West Shell sign down there. Todd puts it right in the middle. 26-20.
They need that to get back in this game. They need a couple more of those. Now they're pressing them.
Well, that offsets the 1 3-point play that Friars got. Look at Sam move. That's a big man on the move.
They might have got close to a 10 seconds call.
Nice call.
It's a very good call. Very good call. I'll tell you what, he's on the ball. I'll tell you what, he's on the verge of 10 seconds right there. He called timeout. Hey, no 10 seconds. He's allowed to do it, too.
Yep.
There was no control. No one had to control the game, or the ball, I mean. Called timeout. Good play. Heads up play. We got 4 minutes and 28 seconds left to go in the third quarter, and Friars are up 26-20, and that's all by height.
I'll tell you what, there's some people missing out on a heck of a ball game here, because this is the smallest crowd we've had, and this is a heck of a, these are two good teams.
Yeah.
I don't think you get two better teams than this.
This is the best right here. These are the best.
Matching up on the inbounds play. There they go. Sam. He's called for a travel, I think. Sam's not supposed to be handling the ball out there. When he gets the ball, he should stop, get the ball to a guard.
Quick hand.
Okay, Bobby Kelly gets the ball from Rizzo. Back to Kelly at the point. He should take that shot. He's just too good a shooter not to shoot that. Kelly to Smiley. Over to Rizzo. Get it underneath. Stubblefield coming across. Good defense. Right over the top of him, though. Good play by Dan Vogel. Showing some toughness down in there with the trees. O'Connor comes up the left side of the floor. Billy Rizzo is fouled by Sean O'Connor. This is what KSC needs to do. They need to get the ball moving around the court, get this team to throw it around a little bit. They have to. They're only down four.
Cut it right to two right now.
Oh, no, bad choice in the pass. Here comes Stubblefield. Kelly's going to come down and beat him. Nice hustling play by Andy Pearson.
Yep.
They can't take the pick in here. And Rizzo shouldn't get down so low. He should come out and play a zone in the middle. You're going to play man-to-man on the inbounds pass under a team's basket. You have to zone the middle. There's what happens. You got too big a guy down in there. 28-22, a 6-point lead for Friars. 3:40 left in the third quarter. Smiley over to Kelly. He should have that one. Well, I'll tell you, Bobby Kelly is a much better shooter than what he is doing tonight. Get the ball back out to Todd Smiley.
Take it.
He had a man in the low post. There he is. Fakes double field up. Goes over the top. No good. Sam Hammer with
by that.
Vice. Nice move to keep from. Oh. Look the ball into your hands. Look the ball into your hands. And if that fails, then you have to look the ball into your hands. Because that's the only way you can catch
a
ball.
If that fails, go underneath the basket and they'll throw it to you.
Now if you're gonna drop it, I ain't never gonna throw it to you.
Good pass.
Nice pass into Pearson, up and in. And he's a money player. Every time
going gets tough, so does Andy.
Get the ball into Sam. Nah, he's putting the ball down too much. Oh, he got three on two on it. Mike Argus, what's he stopping for? Put it in there, Mike. Stubblefield to put it in, right over Pearson. 30-24, still only a six-point lead for Friars. 2:45 left in the third quarter. They get the ball over to Todd. Oh, I don't know how he got that ball through there. Rizzo's way outside, thought about it. Smiley, over to Kelly. Kelly looks, no. That's 25. Dan Lawrence doing a good job over there. Oh, good hustle by Pat Weiss. He just beat Todd Smiley. The ball goes up. Oh, no, he's got to go up strong. Here comes Mike Argus up over the top. No good. Look at the little Todd Smiley come up with that ball. Bobby Kelly comes up, round the back.
She's taking it. She said, stop and took the jumper.
Here's a carry. Good call. Eric Yarbrough didn't like that a bit. Eric's got the intensity going now. He's up, walking the sidelines, a la Bobby Knight. A la. Greg Lurk comes in the ball game, gets it to Kelly. Kelly will not shoot.
Yeah, not looking for it now.
Lurk over to Smiley.
They got to start looking underneath. For it. They got to start moving here.
Gets it to Lurk. Lurk penetrates over to Smiley. Oh, big Sam Hammer with a block. I'm telling you. Oh, what a trot. I don't know how he got it off. Sam with another block. Pearson hammer blocks it again, and he called a foul. I don't think so, though. I think it was another clean block. Foul on big Sam the man Hammer.
Sam the Hammer,
he called him.
Sam the Hammer.
You know, Tony Keller, he, over on the microphone, he played some center over at LaSalle High School. And he's a big boy, and he knows this guy's the Hammer.
Yeah, he knows the Hammer when he sees one.
Yeah, he's seen hammers before. Andy Pearson at the line. Nice shot. Dan Vogel wants underneath, get Todd out of there before he gets stomped on.
Very well could be.
Oh, I'm telling you. Andy Pearson puts the second shot up and in. Just a four-point lead again for Friars. They can't shake this little team. All right, pulled up his dribble when he shouldn't have. Mike Gargis drops the ball on the line. It's going to be KSC ball, and they have a chance of getting back within two now.
Yep.
Smiley's going to inbound to Kelly. Bobby over to Greg Lurk.
They're playing a 1-3-1, Jim. They got to take it down to the wing.
Yep.
They got to take it in the wing. Now they're playing with it outside.
They got to get some baseline screens now against the 1-3-1.
They're not doing anything.
They don't know how to do it right now.
Nope.
Yeah, they have to recognize it, too. Pearson goes up the baseline. Good defense, but Stubblefield.
He's going to make that pass, make a bounce pass, make it hard.
Lawrence brings the ball up, goes through a couple guys. He walked and got away with it. Bobby Kelly's got the ball. He should have been moving. You can't let this team get down here and set up. I'll take it, Bobby.
Yep.
Greg Lurk, he was open. Smiley's open, takes a shot. No good. Argo with a strong rebound. Mike Argus with a real good rebound there. Comes Castleman, number 40, comes up. He went through everybody. I'll tell you something Friars is doing wrong, too. When they get the ball and they force it in, they're not setting up their offense. They got too many big guns. See that? Set up their offense, run their offense.
Right.
Eric's really starting to get frustrated over there. 16 seconds left in the third quarter. And KSC is still hanging tough.
They gotta take one of their shooters and take them down.
Pearson drives up and in. Nice drive to the basket by Andy Pearson. All right, we got a two-point ball game, Gare. Friars is playing too much. They had a chance to put this team away. They were up by 10 at one time. And Shuren Begora, it's not 10 now. KSC is going to get the ball out of bounds. Just 6 minutes left, and it's a two-point ball game. It's anybody's game. Todd Smiley gets the ball from Greg back to Greg Lurk. Argus still out on a point on a 1-2-2 zone. Smiley's open. His hammer comes over and cuts him off. Lurk penetrates. It's not there. Over to Bobby Kelly. Lurk takes the shot. Boom. Nice shot by Greg Lurk.
I can't believe that's his first two. He tied up the game.
Tie score. Ice water in his veins. Sam Hammer gets the ball over to Pat Veith. Pat brings it up on Greg Lurk. Cut off there by Vogel. They fall back. They're in a man-to-man. Lawrence stops, puts it into Sam, guarded by Pearson. Nice fake by Stubblefield, but 3 seconds on number 25, Dan Lawrence.
That's good defense by Smiley, though. I'll tell you what, he was right in there. He had intercepted a pass if it wasn't 3 seconds.
That was good five-man defense for
sure
a man-to-man. They played some tough D. Hey, they can go ahead. And the coach says, go ahead and go ahead. You know what I mean?
They want to go ahead, then go ahead.
Yeah. I mean, give them their head. Greg Lurk has the ball. Oh, he made a bad mistake. Coach Rizzo kicks the chair. Pat Veith on the point. Now they got to run a good man-to-man, solid man-to-man offense. Oh, they got a little isolation play. Nice play by Pearson. They call a foul on him, and I don't know. Looked like a pretty good block. Pat Veith going to the line for two shots, and it is a tie ball game. 4:37 left, and these are big free throws. They're all going to be big down the stretch here.
What kind of pressure should we do?
Poing. Pat's second shot is up off the back of the rim. Big Sam didn't grab the ball, he tapped it. Oh, if he grabs that ball, he goes right back up. Bobby Kelly yo-yos it up over to Greg Lurk. Bobby Kelly way outside. Get the ball to, bad pass. You just can't go cross court, especially against a zone. You just can't do it.
Not against these big wide bodies in there.
Not unless you get a wide open skip pass, and that was nowhere near a skip pass. Whoa, Pat almost committed himself there and had the ball stolen. But you don't leave your feet when a guy's got a dribble up. Good recovery. Stubblefield underneath. Nobody on him. He should have took the shot. Pat Veith into Sam Hammer. Misses the ball. Pearson always there. When you need him, Pearson is there. 30-30. Sounds like a gun. Hot. Okay, they're yelling out the triangle play. We'll see what their triangle play is.
Looks like all the other plays. It looks like to me.
That's the same thing they've been doing all night. Lurk drives the baseline. Not open. Out to Smiley. Sets. Pops. Oh, boom. 32, a two-point lead to Friars, who has 30.
He's
in trouble getting it in.
Plays very good defense.
Yeah. Lawrence took a step, got away with it. Nice rebound in there by Dan Vogel. Gets it out to Smiley, protects the ball, gets it to Bobby Kelly. 3 minutes left. Good ball game.
Yeah, he's gonna make them come out and play man-to-man.
Bobby Kelly gets the penetration over to Greg Lurk.
Oh no. They didn't want that. What? They don't want to force anything. They want to bring it out.
Pat Veith guarded close by Greg. Oh, Pearson almost knocks the ball away from Hammer. Goes to the basket. Tough. Three dribbles and a slam.
Quick.
Yeah, 32 all. Think they're playing for one? Oh. Get it into Vogel. Back out to Well, they're just going to sit on it for a while here, folks. Lurk over to Bobby Kelly. And to Greg. Back to Bobby. Bogle on the baseline out to Greg to get the point. Running some time here. I think they're going for one. What do you think, Coach?
Nah, they want to get out of the zone. They're sitting back in the zone. The coach doesn't. Sit back in there and the other coach.
Oh, bad pass by Greg Lurk. Rizzo comes in the game for Greg Lurk. Full court rat now. Full court rat man to man. Put up the Sam Hammer. He walked and got away with it. Little shuffle step. That's the NBA quick step. Call that. Dan Lawrence tightly guarded by Todd Smiley. Can't get past him. Get it to Mike Argus over in the wing. Hammer walked that time.
They're watching him too.
He's trying to do too much. We got three ones up there, Gary. I want you to see that. All right.
One.
We had three threes, three twos, and three ones tonight.
We have 3 zeros over here. Okay. This is over.
Isn't life interesting? I'll tell you.
Full surprises.
I'm telling you. Rizzo loses his footing. Pat Veith, real nice, good foul by Bobby Kelly, because now he's going to the line, maybe, if they're in a one-on-one.
I don't think so. I don't think so.
I think it was a good foul to give up.
I think that's your third.
Sean O'Connor comes into the game, replacing Dan Lawrence. Pat Veith going to inbounds. There's Big Sam underneath. Nice defensive play. Nice defensive play. I want to tell you, that was slick.
Yeah, sure.
Bobby Kelly used his quickness to get in behind that pass, and he knocked it right off of Sam Hammer's leg.
Okay, they got 54 seconds. Let's see what they're going to do. I'm sure they're going to hopefully go for one.
I would. The thing is, they're out in a man now. I'd run my stall. You got to have a stall for something like this.
Don't pick up your dribble when you're out there either.
Yeah, good call.
45 seconds.
Okay, good basketball game.
Sure is.
I enjoy this strategic game like this. This is really going to be fun here at the end. Well, Garrett, good night.
That sure has.
We had a good night.
A lot of interesting ball games. We had a couple blowouts, but still things surprised us.
Well, I'll tell you what. When this game started, Friars came out, and I thought, well, this one's over. But
hung tight, didn't it?
KSC is, as always, is there at the end. Don't I know so well?
Yeah. I never had to put up with them too much. We're always just as big as them, and we were maybe a little bit meaner.
Well, coaches were meaner over here.
Yeah, major players meaner.
Tell you what, there's been a great rivalry over the last 10 years between Friars Club, Northside KSC, and Cheviot Fire. All three organizations have been going at each other jaw to jaw. Friars and KSC have gone at each other longer, the last 20 years. Okay, I think they're playing for one. Smiley to Kelly to Smiley.
The shooters they got, that's not a bad idea.
That's right. Take your shot.
They got their ball handlers, ball handling the ball. They've got 10 seconds left.
Here we go. Now they'll run it. Pearson, Smiley, Rizzo, Smiley, Pearson drives. Bobby Kelly at the buzzer! Whoa! Bobby Kelly with a running one-hander off the baseline.
Oh, that's an exciting
game. At the buzzer, KSC.
What a game.
Defeats one good Friars team.
Boy, oh boy.
34-32.
Friars are over there stunned. They're stunned. I'll tell you what.
I know Eric Yarborough was over there planning what he was going to do in overtime, but Bobby Kelly was Johnny on the spot. And I'm going to tell you, folks, you can't get a better game than that. That was a very, very interesting basketball game. We've seen four good games here tonight. And next week, you folks want to get up here and see these games in person, because this game here, we needed about 50,000 people watching this game, because this was a real good ball game. Any last thoughts, Gare?
No, not for me. Come on up next week. I'll tell you what, same time, same place.
Okay, we'll see you all next week. Be back the same time. Bye. Thank you.
now we'll say bye.